Hi guys, I am Leonardo and I want to teach you about how to place characters in a perspective drawing, especially for animation, because you need to place your characters and make it move around a picture, not a 3D environment. So this illustration was made using Clip Studio Paint with the perspective rulers, as you can see. And if you are interested to see how did I make this drawing, I have an article in Clip Studio Tips showing the entire process. In general terms, this is a two-point perspective illustration. You can see the horizontal line. This represents how high a camera or our observer is. In this case, I place my horizontal line at 1.8 meter high. So I know that this line represents 1.8 meters anywhere in the perspective. So I want to show you these two. When you create a new illustration, in my case, let's use A4 and 300 resolution. You can go to Edit, and in the Canvas property, check the comic settings. Let's make the canvas a little bigger because I want to use HD resolution. So maybe 2000 per 1300. Now, the frame will be full HD, so 1920 per 1080. And this option will be 0. And change the set size to set margin. This will be the safe area. And for full HD, this safe area will be 52 in top bottom and 96 for inside outside. In this case, everything outside of the box can be trimmed when exported. Let's make the area outside of the rectangle in red to see how it looks. Maybe I'm going to erase these parts that are inside the square. Now, in the file export, single layer, I'm going to use whatever name, 01. In range, select two inside crop mark. Now, okay. And you can see the export preview that there is no red anywhere. The red was trimmed away. So the area I'm going to export will be clean. If you do this again and select all pages, the result will be to export the entire frame, including the red areas. So, I use these options here to create my background frame at the correct resolution. And now, when I export the image, remember to change the selection to inside of crop mark. The image will be the size I need for the animation. In a new file, I will create an animation file. And in this, you can see I have two templates, one for full HD and another for 4K resolution. These are the settings for the template, you can see there. In the description box, there is a link if you want to download the file for these templates. Now, in the background folder, let's import the image we create for this scene. We need to place it in the correct position, and this is the result we're going to get. You can use Ctrl 0 to create a full frame of the drawing area. Now, let's import the 3D character. I will use this one I download for free from the asset store. Just click and drag into the drawing area. Change the camera angle to a three-quarter view. I think this is better. To create a two-point perspective. All 3D characters have a hidden perspective ruler. So you can show this ruler to adjust the character. Using this icon, you can move the character in the perspective. But you can see the character is not in the correct perspective yet. To place the character in the correct perspective, click over the character ruler and change the position of the ruler to match the height of the horizontal line. Remember that in the illustration, the horizontal line was in the red area of the painting. So you can adjust this position. And then using the vanishing point handles, place the lines to coincide to the lines of the illustration, like this. Move the lines to the correct vanishing point. And we need to do the same for the other vanishing points with the reference line. Now the character is in the correct perspective. You can check that all the lines are correctly pointing to the vanishing point. Now, when you move the character in the environment, you can see it's in the proper perspective. But the character is too big, so to correct that, I will go to Display Object List and in Allocate, we need to change the object scale to the one that suits the character. In my case, I like the character to be around 175 meters high, but we can do it by eye. You can place the character near to an object that is interesting. And you can adjust the height of the character to the one you are looking for. Now, when you move the girl in the scene, it looks perfectly integrated to the environment. It almost looks like if the environments were a 3D asset too. I use Clip Studio Paint EX, so the next option is not available in the Pro version. But I think it's really useful for placing characters in an environment. The pro users can do it, but it will be harder. So, what we need to do is to go to Window and activate All Side View. This shows the characters in top, side, front, and a perspective view. Using this window, you can place the figure with great control. For example, you can rotate your character and it will immediately reflect the movement in the environment or in the canvas. Besides, in the perspective view, I can fine-tune the position and the camera position of this window will not affect the model in my canvas. If you do this in the canvas, you will need to adjust the perspective every time you change the camera position. So it's not too good. To create an animation, I will duplicate the 3D layer of the initial pose and copy and paste the 3D object. This is to have a reference of the initial position and change just the parts I need to create the next position. This is kind of a straight ahead animation. Using this method, I can create key position for the animation. This will be extremely time consuming if you paint the character by hand, because you will invest a lot of time making sure that the character is in the right perspective, and then you need to paint the key positions and then do the in-betweens. And for sure you will need to create several raw drawings until you get it right, and then get right the animation in the perspective. This method lets you concentrate in the correct creation of the key position for the animation. When I have the desired position for the 3D model, I can erase the copy of the first position to keep the model clean. Having the previous pose in the same layer helps you to keep consistency in the movement you like to create, and you can erase the previous position or paste it when you need it. In this animation, I want the girl to start moving from a standing pose, going toward the camera, and then going back to the same position. If you don't know how to move the 3D figure in Clip Studio Paint, I put a link in the description to a video that explains the process in more detail. For the example, I create these three main poses. I'm going to lower the transparency of the background to see better my model. Now, in Layer, LT Converting Layer, I can convert the 3D model to lines and shapes, just adjusting the settings to the ones you like and click OK. This is the result. You get a folder with different layers. You can erase some or keep everything. If you want, you can select the layers and merge everything in one layer, or you can do this to the folder too. I create an auto action to do this faster. And I put a button in the quick access window, so I just do this in one click. I get the right effect, the model is now nice, it's a basic drawing, and I can use it to make the in-betweens. I can do it again for the next pose. This is fast and convenient. Now I will show the file with the finished animation. I create all the poses for the model, and I place these 3D models in an animation folder to adjust the timing of the animation. You can see the 3D model animated in time, but just the key positions. There is no way you can do all the animation this way. Then I convert the models to lines and paint all the in-betweens. And you can see this is my rough animation. This is the layer for the clean lines for the animation. All the details of the characters are there. Now, I will make visible all the layers for the characters, including an adjusting layer for the animation. Now I will activate the background to see my complete animation. You can see this is a powerful method to create animation in 3D. These are really hard to do because there are so many things that you need to keep in mind when you are doing it. And if you use the 3D models, it's like having extra help, and you can concentrate in doing what you need, that is animate, not create the right perspective for every drawing. So I hope you like it. I'm going to continue creating some tutorials about animation. I really like the subject. I hope I can see you in the next video. Thanks, bye.
Mm-hmm.